Welcome to level 9. This is super exciting. Halfway point. Well, the beginning of the halfway point. Not quite as dramatic as the beginning of the end, but, you know, small steps. The journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single cliche. Alright, so, what is that? I don't know. Let's go up the stairs so I don't have to fight it right away. Well, it's probably not going to follow me up the stairs, is it? The enemies are dumb, but they're not that dumb. Alright, well, let's go toe-to-toe. I saved my game, even though I didn't save it in the video, in yesterday's video. I saved it after I stopped recording. So if I die, then I just, I'm right back at the beginning. What is... Ugh. It has, like... a Joker grimace. And then... It's like greenish, but only at a certain angle. That was really, really unsettling. Alright, let's find out what this thing is. Looks like a... Oh, a hag. Okay, well. Sounds unpleasant, but... Not... Oh, wow, 15... Wow, there are a lot of these things. Oh, God. They're laughing at me. Don't laugh at me. Well, remember, I have my heal, so even though I'm in a pitiable situation here, if I get knocked down to the doors of death, which seems to be right about now. Flame strike! Well, that worked. I don't know if these things are considered undead. They look like they might be. It's hard to tell, honestly. I mean, they seem to have trouble hitting me, but I can't tell if it was the amount of trouble they would have if they were undead and I'm invisible to them. Level 12 already, wow. This would be another flesh golem then. Alright. Hold person, I'll hold on to that scroll. The reason I came back to these steps is because I want to ditch some of these keys I'm not going to need. These are keys that I didn't use on the previous levels for whatever reason, and I just don't want to get confused as to why I have them in my inventory. And I should go ahead and re-equip my shield. Alright, is it just those two? I think so. Yeah. This is some nice music. Once again, Etrian Odyssey 4. Yuzo Koshiro. Musical genius. Alright, level 12. Wow, do I have level 7 spells yet? No, not quite yet. I do have more of every other level of spell, though. Well, let's see. So get another Cure Light. I'm not really using Detect Magic right now, so I'll get rid of that. I only need one protection from evil, really. As much healing as possible. And... Yeah, so get another aid. I mean, I haven't been poisoned or anything yet. Neither of these enemies seem to use cold or fire. Don't need to remove curse at the moment. Probably don't need protection from fire. Wait. Oh, resist fire and protection from fire. I see. This must be a just more powerful version of resist fire. Okay. So what do I need then? Probably just prayers. I'll go ahead and get a crate of food and water too. I mean, I really don't need that many prayers, but I don't think there are any other level 3 spells I really need at the moment. I guess I could try Magical Vestment. I mean, it might be doing some good. It's hard to tell. Level 4, we're good. Level 5, also good. Level 6, I have one more of these. Nice. I think I'll try out Sol Searing Orb. Hang on to heal. I mean, Hero's Feast, I mean, it's nice that it cures all those status ailments. But it's usually not going to be that much better than just normal create food and water. So I hope everyone's having a good Tuesday. trying to keep what days these videos actually go up straight, since I record them in advance. Pretty sure this one's going up Tuesday, because the one I just recorded is going up Monday. That would seem to make sense. Actually, I have 3 pages of level 1 spells now, which is kind of neat. It's the first time that barrier has been broken. So I have that lone turn undead down there that I've never really used. Never really had a reason to. Alright, so I have 2 attack spells now, Flame Strike and Sol's Searing Orb. So I'll have to remember I have those. Do not have that key yet. So I finished watching / listening to the Let's Play Fallout, or Let's Get On With It Fallout, as he calls it, Grimithar. I mentioned him a couple videos ago. Oh, Illusionary Wall, nice. Man, that is a heck of a game, the original Fallout. Really wish I had the patience to actually finish that game when I tried playing it. I've tried playing it a couple times. The last time was just a couple years back. And man, that game, it's very, very slow. It's kind of like trying to play the original Diablo. That game was also very slow. At least, you know, by the standards of today's games. But, I mean, it's good. The story for the original Fallout is excellent. The voice acting is all fantastic. The dialogue is all really well written. The combat's interesting. It's more interesting to watch someone who knows what he's doing than to try to suss it out yourself. -2 and 1. No thanks. And also, I mean, I did other stuff while I had Fallout on in the background. I was either working or playing a video game of some kind. It's a long video series, about 25 hours total. But yeah, it's very good. I'll probably start watching his Fallout 2 videos next. Fallout 2 being a game that I have zero experience with. Never even tried it because couldn't make it past Fallout 1. Maybe this is the kind of barrier that I can bash. I don't know. Maybe I need an actual melee weapon to bash it. Nope. Seems to be absolutely solid. Weird. It's kind of weird that most of my video game consumption recently has been watching or listening to other people play games. Like, I've been doing that way more than I've been playing games myself. But hopefully this should be the last week I have overtime at work, which has really just been taking up all of my time. Like, April just went by. Like, I don't even remember most of April because I was working for so much of it. I mean, that's an exaggeration, but I mean, really, I get home from work and I have like 3 hours until I have to go to bed. And then I'm working on Saturdays as well. But you know, there's an illusionary wall straight ahead. Yeah, thanks. The one I already found. Very, very astute of you. But you know, the pay will be worth it. I already spent some of my overtime pay, as I mentioned in yesterday's video. I got a Nexus 7 Android tablet. I bought it on SA Mart, the forum on Something Awful for buying and selling stuff. Got a pretty good deal on it. Came with a case and a keyboard, Bluetooth keyboard. So that would pretty much replace my netbook, which I hated lugging around my netbook. I have the the extended battery on it, because otherwise it lasts like an hour before the battery dies. But the extended battery is just heavy and cumbersome. I know, first world problems. I mean, it's a portable computer, but yeah, I'm excited. There are a bunch of Android games that I really like, and my main reason for buying it is because my Android phone that I was using, it was a Droid Bionic, which is about three or four years old at this point. It stopped charging. The charging port on it, or the USB port, I'm pretty sure just got a short in it or something. It just stopped working. So I can no longer... I mean, if you finagle the cord just right, then it'll recognize that it's plugged in and it'll start charging, which is really weird. But like every time I tried to set it to charge overnight, like it would be dead when I woke up in the morning. So I guess it wasn't finagled well enough. But yeah, I was mostly using it to listen to podcasts and audiobooks at work, which I can still do. I have a 2 gigabyte MP3 player, just a crappy $15 thing that I bought on eBay. But it did the job. It was just really, really inconvenient. So yeah, that's probably the only, extravagance I'm going to get with all of this extra money that I have. The rest of it, I'm really going to have to start saving back, because I don't really have a nest egg or anything. This probably is not entertaining narration for Dungeon Hack. But I was kind of worried I would run into this problem with this game. After a point, there's just really not that much to say about it. I mean, every level's kind of the same. There are two new monsters that you have to fight. Once you figure out how the monsters work, then it's no longer really interesting. I mean, both of these monsters seem not really a huge deal. The Flesh Golem is, it's slow as heck. Doesn't really seem to have any attack other than just walking up to you and just punching you, or whatever it's doing. And then this thing, it's very amused, I'll give it that. Where the heck is my hammer going? It was flying all over the room. That was so weird. I mean, it's very amused, but the amusement doesn't really seem to translate into a significant amount of damage. However, if my hammer doesn't keep... Oof. Oh my god, would you just die? I need to heal myself. I should just heal myself now, but I want to kill you first. Oh, so much for these enemies being pushovers. Jeez, why can't I hit anything all of a sudden? My hammer just took on a mind of its own. Is the hag, like, cursing my hammer or something? Wait, did I kill it? Okay, good. I don't see it. Okay, that must have been the same one. It just traveled across the room a little bit. Okay, anyway. But yeah, I mean, once you reach a certain point with this game, there's not really a lot of new stuff to talk about. Oh my god. I'm hurting. Not gonna break out the heal just yet, since I have all these cure serious wounds and whatnot. Sneaking up on me while I'm healing. Another crystal key. Great. Another, oh my, ugh. It would be really awesome if this game would give you an item occasionally, just every once in a while, an item besides a key. I mean, I know I'm asking for a lot, but jeez, it just feels kind of insulting when I find 3 crystal keys on the same level of a dungeon. Like, who designed this garbage? I mean, it's almost like this dungeon was created by a random number generator. But that's crazy talk. Oh, there's the entrance. Wow. I really have not made a lot of progress. Okay. At least there aren't 50 billion teleporters in this one. I'll take one of those. Thank you. I feel better. Ow. You know, that's really not what I imagine when I think of a flesh golem. When I think of flesh golem, I think of, like, the thing that Tetsuo turns into at the end of Akira. Only on a smaller scale. Like, just a walking, dripping mound of flesh. Nope. Oh. Thank you for reminding me to equip my shield. The only time I remember to equip my shield is when I realize that my armor class is -2 instead of -4. Well, this laughing really isn't going to get annoying or anything. They didn't really think that sound effect through. Kind of like in a Daggerfall LP I was watching. There were these guards, and they would say halt. Kind of like enemies in Wolfenstein, but the rate at which they said it, I mean, they just said halt ad nauseum. Especially if there was more than one of them, it was just a chorus of halt, 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 and so on. And I'm sure the sound effect sounds fine when they came up with it, but they don't realize that it's going to be played at you 100 trillion times. You know, I kind of wish my character didn't point out illusionary walls that I already found. I mean, it just doesn't make me feel that good about my character's intelligence. I mean, I know my intelligence is only 13, but that should still be enough not to say, you know, I think there's an illusionary wall here. Call it explorer's intuition, but there's something not right about that wall. Yes, thank you. Now, if you say that before I walk through the wall, you know, that's one thing. But for some reason, that never really seems to happen. Frost key. No. No. I don't have that key. Boy, why couldn't you be asking for one of the three crystal keys I have? Alright, well, all my spells, my buffs ran out. Oops, I forgot to close Skype. Sorry, guys. Hopefully that wasn't too loud on the video. Oops! I already have one of those. I guess I don't really need protection from evil or whatever else I had on me. Alright, so I need is that copper? That's either copper or brass. I need one of those, and I need a frost key. Alright, well, where else can I go? That door doesn't open from the side. Okay, there's a direction down here I haven't gone, and up here. Good. Ah, there we go. One down, two to go. The music's very excited that I just opened that door. I kind of wish I knew what my other Ion Stone did. I mean, these enemies could have, you know, devastating effects that I'm just not aware of because I'm immune to whatever they're doing. In which case, you know, I'm happy, obviously. I'm glad to be protected in that case, but it's kind of a bummer not to even know that I'm being protected. Uh-oh. Okay. I saw myself about to get surrounded there, and I started to worry. Alright, what kind of healing do I have? Okay, I have some cure serious ones, so I should be in good shape. And I have heal if the shit really hits the fan. So I haven't really needed to try out my my damage spells recently. And I know I should watch what I say, because as soon as I say something like that, the game will throw something at me that is just unkillable unless I start throwing magic at it. Another Brigandine. Well, I doubt it's better than what I have. Nope.
That human just threw armor at me. What the heck?
That's what I imagine flesh golem sound like, you know. Not, you know, stupid, but just a little slower than a normal human. I mean, when you think about it, isn't every person a flesh golem? I mean, a golem is just a humanoid figure made out of some kind of material, like a stone golem or a straw golem or what have you. So a flesh golem is just a human made out of human material. AKA a human. Boy, I bet some people would not be happy about that concept in a game that children are playing. You know, a creature constructed from human flesh to look like a man. Hey, oh man, it's probably just that dumb amulet of nothing, isn't it? Pretty sure once you find an amulet, every amulet that looks the same is the same. I don't have detect magic or anything, but I'm pretty sure that's just a necklace of... They call it a necklace of adornment in D&D. Hey! Well, that's just dang rude. Putting spikes there. And I'm gonna have to walk back over the spikes. Great, maybe I can lure this thing onto the spikes and make it take some extra damage. Oops. It doesn't look like it's coming this way. Come on, you big galoot. Oops, crap! Yes, immediately wall back onto the spikes. Good job, Duke. Okay. I should probably rest. I memorized create food and water, right? Yeah. My spells are good. I'm not going to go in and double check them. So far, I don't really need any spells other than the usual on this level. So let's see, what else have I been up to? Not much. It's pretty much just been working in this. So I don't really have much else to talk about. I mean, I've been reading at work on my lunch break. I just finished reading 1Q84 by, I'm gonna butcher his name, Haruki Murakami. Really famous Japanese author, probably the best known one. A friend of mine recommended one of his books, Norwegian Wood, and I've read Norwegian Wood and another book by him, The Wind-Up Bird Chronicle. I read those last month, and then this month I read 1Q84, which is just gigantic. It's basically three books in one. It's like 1,000 pages. But they were all really, really good. I think he's become one of my favorite authors. I don't read a lot of literary fiction, and I should probably change that. Like, I tend to read, you know, historically, since I was a kid, I tend to read mostly genre fiction. And, I mean, there's nothing wrong with genre fiction at all. I love sci-fi and fantasy and all that. But, you know, it's good to broaden your horizons. Holy crap. This is not a good situation. Well, okay. Oh my god. Alright, one of the enemies got bored and went up that hallway. So if I can kill this flesh golem and sneak past it. Okay, good. At least now I'm not surrounded. So yeah, when I'm only reading for like an hour a day, it tends to go pretty slowly. Which is why that was the only book I read in April. But, you know, I'm looking for new stuff to read now. If you have any recommendations, let me know. Recommendations for literary fiction, especially. I mean, you know, genre fiction is great, like I said, but... Man, there's just something about a really great, just straight-up fiction book when it's really well-written and it really gets you drawn into it. It's just fantastic. I thought about how I like to experience stories kind of a lot. And I think I've determined that for a long story, my favorite medium for that is a book, a novel, like for drama anyway. For short fiction, for short drama, I prefer watching a movie, because I mean short stories are great, but you know, they're, you read them and they're over in like 15 minutes to half an hour, and a 2-hour movie that's really well done can kind of, you know, amplify the experience. I mean, even if it's the same story, a short story, I mean, I prefer it. I mean, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with reading a short story, but my preference would be to watch a movie to get that kind of story. And I'm not really into, like, the long-form dramatic TV shows. Like, everyone talks about stuff like Breaking Bad and True Detective, and, you know, they all sound really good. And, like, I started watching Breaking Bad, and I got really into it for a couple seasons. But then I just couldn't keep it up. There was just way too much of it. And, I mean, I guess it's weird for me to say that when I just spent a month reading a book. But, you know, the only reason I had less time to read was because I was working so much overtime. It wouldn't have taken me that long if I had actually, you know, read more than just on my lunch break. It hurt to step there. There's not even anything here. What's wrong with you? Ow! Oh my god, it's this whole hallway. What the F? That doesn't seem to be... Finally, I'm tired of getting hurt with every step I take. Huh. That is so weird. Oops. I don't know why I cast prayer. But yeah, for comedy, my preferred method of comedy is actually television shows. Like, I really love one-off, you know, non-serialized comedy TV shows, like The Simpsons and Futurama and all that. Minus three. Wow, the Brigandine is better than... Oh, wait, no. The Playmail is one better than the Brigandine. Nice. I hope that doesn't have some effect on me. Because I remember in D&D, in tabletop D&D. Plate mail, like, if you're not a fighter or someone with, like, a ton of strength, plate mail isn't a great choice. But I'm not really sure that carries over to dungeon hack. Another field plate, wow. They're both minus five. Alright. Okay. I'm going the wrong way. Oh, right. I can't go through the store. There's no button. Just double and triple checking just to make absolutely sure. Okay. So if I can't go through that door, where should I go? Looks like I need to go over in this area. I have this hallway to explore, and then I can start going down there. Okay. Well, I'm kind of disappointed that this path ended in a dead end like that, because I have quite a ways to go to make it back to somewhere I'm making progress. Maybe I should rest now that I'm kind of isolated from monsters, since I used a lot of healing recently. Now you might ask, okay, so that's movies, TV, and books. What about video games? And I do like video games with good stories. They're very rare. Video games are the best at... this is going to sound tautological, but video games are the best at giving you a story, giving you an interactive story. And mostly I go to video games for the mechanics. Like, obviously, I don't go to a game like Dungeon Hack for the story. But video games like... probably the best recent examples are the Portal games and the Walking Dead adventure game by Telltale. And those are just... They're two different ways of blending storytelling with interactivity in such a masterful way that you couldn't do that in any other medium. You can make a Portal 2 movie, it would not have the same impact that Portal 2 the game had. Obviously, for people who haven't played the game, you know, it would be really awesome. But it's not going to be the same as playing the game. And there are so few games that really take advantage of that. It's kind of sad. Alright, so I can't go through either of these doors, still. I have to go all the way back to the beginning, wow. Alright, well, there's a couple little areas here that I still have to check out. So yeah, I don't know when video games, as a medium, will become, like, a go-to storytelling device. The number one thing I go to video games for is the game part. Still, even in 2014. Like, you could show me the best big budget AAA game ever made, and odds are it probably won't really affect me that much. Now, obviously, there's a lot of recent stuff that I haven't played, because I don't have, I do have... I have access to an Xbox 360 that I'm borrowing, but I don't have a PS3, and I'm sure if I played The Last of Us, that would probably be an effective blend of storytelling and interactivity, because Naughty Dog really, really knows their stuff. So that's one recent example that I'm adding to my honorable mentions list. And I heard that Spec Ops The Line, kind of similarly, does really cool things with storytelling and gameplay, storytelling and mechanics, and that's a game that's been on my list for a while. I really want to check that game out. From everything I hear about Bioshock Infinite, I don't think I'll be that impressed with it. I wasn't that impressed with the original Bioshock. It felt like it was... Its bark was bigger than its bite. It felt like they were trying to make Bioshock this big, impactful, like, meaningful thing. But it got so bogged down in being, like, a triple-A shooter, at least from what I played of it, that none of it really seemed meaningful in any way. And, there's that copper key. Would have been nice if I found that a while ago. But yeah, I'd still like to play The Last of Us one of these days. I kept saying I would get a PS3 when they got cheap, once the PS4 came out. And PS3 still aren't cheap enough for me to consider going that route. But one of these days, I will play it. I'm trying to think of other recent examples. I'm sure there have been some. Papers, Please is another one that a lot of people have mentioned, and it's another game that's on my list that I haven't played. I mean, I guess my philosophy, kind of sadly, is if I want a story, I'll watch a movie or read a book. Like, if people tell me that the reason I should play a game is the story, unless it's like a really short experience, like the Blendo games, Gravity Bone and 30 Flights of Loving, those are other cool recent examples. Oh, I already opened that. And those games are like 15 minutes each, which is fine. It's the video game short story. I didn't think that would fit, but I thought, oh, there it is. So yeah, storytelling in games still has a long way to go. It'll be a while before video games are something I jump to as a way to experience a story. Which, I mean, isn't to say that games that don't have a story are bad. I mean, I'm having a ton of fun with Dungeon Hack, even though, you know, the story is as bare bones as it could possibly get in a video game. I mean, as much as I like RPGs, like long RPGs with huge storylines and tons of characters and all that, I would never play those games if they didn't have interesting combat mechanics. And that's kind of been my problem with a lot of RPGs recently. See, Etrian Odyssey, it goes the opposite direction. It does away with the story almost completely. I mean, there's really, at least so far, there's really no story elements to Etrian Odyssey 4. And it's 100% mechanics, and I think it's better for it. Because like I mentioned, I played Etrian Odyssey Untold, and the only thing it really brings to the table that the other Etrian Odyssey games don't have is a quote-unquote story. And, I mean, nothing against it, but the quote-unquote story seemed kind of like a steaming pile of trash. Really fun mechanics. You know, awesome combat. The exploration was really fun. But, you know, don't shoehorn in a story where it's not necessary. I don't really know where I'm going with all this. I'm kind of rambling. But Dungeon Hack kind of necessitates rambling. Still fighting hags, still fighting flesh golems. You know, I want to say it would be more interesting if there were more than two types of enemies on every floor. But at the same time, I don't really want to have to deal with all that. Like, if there are levels that have enemies that use fire, and enemies that use cold, and enemies that use poison, and enemies that can paralyze you, and enemies that can drain your levels, you don't want to have to deal with all that because you don't want to have to memorize that many spells. You don't want to have to rest over and over and over again to get all the spells you would need to survive a level. So, from my perspective, I'm glad there are only two enemy types per floor, But from your guys' perspective, I can see why it would be kind of boring. The end. Wait, this was just that other field plate that, that I determined wasn't better than what I have, right? Yeah. But hey, reminded me to put on my shield. Oh, crap. It's the pain zone again. Okay, well, now that I have the frost key, I can open... which door was it? I guess it's that door, but I don't have to open it now that I've explored both sides. So I just need to go to that one hallway that I haven't been down yet. And you know, totally not saying... Oh wait, I cannot go that way. Interesting. Is there another door that I haven't unlocked? No. There's not, just that one. I mean, I'm pretty sure that's just the frost door. And unlocking it won't do me any good. Well, grasshoppers, there must be a secret door that I haven't found somewhere. Which means it's time for everyone's favorite RPG activity. Mash your face against the walls. I mean, I'm on the edge of the map, so I guess it doesn't do me any good to look for secret passages on that side. I'm making my way back to the pain hallway, but I really don't want to have to go all the way around, so I guess I'll just deal with it. Wait, was that a different kind of enemy I just heard? That was a different sound from the hag and the flesh golems. Pretty sure. Well, where have I not looked for secret doors? Crap. I'm gonna have to end up going all the way back around anyway. I need to go down this hallway so I can search for doors here. Even though I feel like I already searched around here. It's just this area that I still need to hit. Well, I am officially out of stuff to talk about. I mean, me talking about how I like to experience different kind of stories is, that was on my emergency list of topics. I was like, well, if I absolutely don't have anything else to talk about and I need to fill some dead air, I guess I can talk about how I feel about stories. And you know, none of those rules are like set in stone either. I mean, there are comedy books that I like. There have been drama TV shows that I like. I mean, I really love Cowboy Bebop. That's one of my favorite shows ever. And even though it's a serialized... Well, I guess the reason I like Cowboy Bebop so much is that it's not really as serialized as a lot of other anime shows. Because like, with something like Dragon Ball Z, which I loved as a kid, but you know, I couldn't go back and watch it now. You know, it's hyper serialized. I mean, there are episodes where like nothing happens except the characters like continuing an argument from the previous episode, and there are arguments that stretch out into like multi episode arcs. And I mean, they're like B stories and C stories, but yeah, Cowboy Bebop is kind of the opposite of Dragon Ball Z. Like, it has, I think, 26 episodes, but each one is kind of self-contained, and there is an overarching plot, but it's kind of secondary to... Oh, there we go. I don't want to say it's like Monster of the Week, because they're not necessarily fighting monsters, but it's more like... you know, I mean, it's a weird comparison, but it's kind of like Star Trek. There's just a different problem every week that the crew of the Bebop has to solve. And some of those problems are linked throughout episodes, but for the most part, they're pretty standalone. But I mean, still, it's an example of a dramatic TV show I like. So, you know, there are exceptions to every rule. You know, there are short stories that I really like that I don't think would work well as movies. Harlan Ellison's I Have No Mouth But I Am a Scream comes to mind. I don't think that would work really well as a movie. Although there's a video game for that one. Oh wait, I don't want to rest yet. Oh, crap. Oh well, I guess I'm okay. There's a video game for I Have No Mouth But I Am a Scream that looks really interesting, and I've kind of avoided looking up anything about it because I want to go in not knowing anything about it. Since I mean Harlan Ellison actually worked on the game. He had creative influence over it. So I want to see, you know, I want to see what that's like. But yeah, exceptions to every rule. Well, not every rule. I mean, don't drink from bottles labeled poison is a pretty solid rule. I don't think there are any exceptions to that one. Oops. Wait, what do you mean the key won't fit in the... Oh. I guess the key won't fit in the lock. I guess I need that key. That's another rule with very few exceptions. The right key for the right lock. It's kind of warm in here. I wonder if this microphone would pick up the air conditioner. Because I got a new microphone. Level 13. Booyah. What do I get? Nope, no level 7 spells yet. But I get an extra level 4 spell. I'm not going to rest yet. But next time I rest, I'll go in and pray for spells and get all the new stuff. Break camp. Okay. But yeah, my old microphone, I mean, it's a good microphone. It's cardioid. But... What? That was a weird noise. The reason I got a new microphone was because my old microphone was going through a mixing board that was just going through my audio input on my motherboard. I don't have like a dedicated sound card or anything, and I don't have room to put a dedicated sound card in there, and I felt like I would have better audio quality if I was using some sort of USB microphone. So I got one of those Blue Yetis, and I think it sounds pretty good. It sounds a lot better than what I was using, but it doesn't seem to be able to isolate sound quite as nicely as my cardioid microphone could. And it has different modes. I'm using what's called cardioid mode. And it seems to isolate my voice pretty well, but it still picks up, like, you can hear the keys clacking a lot more. It's a lot more pronounced than it would be if I was using my other microphone. So it's kind of a trade-off. You trade one type of quality for another type of quality. So I'm not sure if I can turn my AC on or not. Which, I mean, you know, it's only May. Once we get into, like, July and August, I'll probably have to start leaving my AC on most of the time. Hey, food. It's too bad I just cast great food and water, and I don't need you anymore. Boy, that's quite a statement to make, isn't it? I don't need food anymore. Clerics are the original breatharians. They are able to sustain themselves only on the divine energy of their creator. It's kind of beautiful when you think about it. Things are getting pretty serious. And when things get serious, it's time to cure serious. Ow! It's another dang trap. Okay. It wasn't as long as the previous pain area. I don't really have an explanation for that area. I mean, I don't know if it's a trap or if it's like, if there's, well, it says hurt with every step I take, so that would make me think that it's something on the floor, but it doesn't look like there's anything on the floor, so I don't know. Here, fleshy, fleshy, fleshy. I've got a hammer for you. Man, that's really gross. I should never say the word fleshy again. Alright, okay. Oops. Got ahead of myself there. Alright, I'm getting pretty close to the end. Oops. Dang it. Pretty sure the stairs are going to be at the end of this hallway. Or somewhere nearby. I guess I still have a little bit to finish up here. Oh. Looks like an Ankh. Oh! See, I always get the Holy Key and the Key of Faith mixed up. Because the Holy Key, I don't really think of the Ankh as a holy symbol. And it's more of a symbol of... I mean, it's just a symbol of life. It doesn't really have any holy properties. I guess it probably does in some religion. It's probably... I shouldn't talk about stuff I don't know anything about. I mean, it's an ancient Egyptian symbol, right? That's where it originated. But there might be other cultures that it's more meaningful for. Boy, I will be really glad when I never have to hear the laugh of a hag again. If I ever hear another hag again, it'll be too soon. Let's chill to the music for a little bit. This is good music. And also, I'm still grasping at straws for things to talk about. Once the busy season of work ends, I'll be able to do more stuff, and I'll actually have stuff to talk about, which will be nice. I'm playing a lot smarter now. There are definitely situations where I could have gotten trapped, and I was able to sidestep it. Still haven't met the boss of this level, have I? I imagine that's probably coming up soon. I heard it earlier. At least I think I did. It sounded monstrous in nature. Might want to rest before I encounter the boss, because all I have left... Well, no, I still have heal, so... If things really start to go south, then... I have that in the reserves. Oh! That's a scorpion. Okay. How do you feel about... Oh man, that's a spell that requires a hand? I thought it was just a projectile that you can cast. Well, that's interesting. I guess that might replace my spiritual hammer. But I lost it. I'm going to have to pray for spells again to get it back. Alright, Scorpion. How do you feel about Flame Strike? You seemed okay with it. Scorpion did not have a problem with the Flame Strike. As the Scorpion approaches, I grab its tail and stab it to death with its own stinger. That doesn't work. The scorpion's immune to its own poison. Oh, crap. Oh, no. Scorpion at 6 o'clock. Please die, hag. Please die, hag. Thank you. Well, I don't think the scorpion hit me. How much you want to bet that scorpion has a poison attack? Alright, do I have a protection from poison scroll? Because if I do, I can just go toe-to-toe with this thing. There we go. Protection from poison. Oh, did my spiritual ham... Oh, no, it's probably just... There it is. Alright, scorpion. Show me what you got. It looks more like an electricity attack than poison, to be perfectly honest. Is that like a mechanical scorpion? I guess it is. It does look sort of robotic. Uh-oh. I shouldn't have gone that way. That was a bad move. Alright. What is my strategy? Maybe I should use protection from electricity. Yeah, that's a good idea. Let's see if that actually is electricity. Alright, put my holy symbol back in my hand. Maybe I could hold it. Hopefully the scorpion just has a few hits left, but it seems pretty tough. Alright, so I cast whole person. It probably won't work on a scorpion now that I think of it, since a scorpion's not a person. I can throw a potion of confusion at it. Well, let's get a few more hits in. Maybe I might not have to... Oh, there we go. No more resources required. Scroll of Heroes Feast, hey? That'll come in handy. Alright, is this an amulet I can use? Nope. It's an amulet I can wear. Is it cursed? Nope. Well, do I have any other amulets I can wear? I don't think so. So I might as well wear that one. See if I can figure out what it does. Does it affect any of my stats? Does not appear to. Alright, well, hopefully it does something good. Did my hammer... Oh wait, no, my hammer's there. I need to either put my holy symbol or my shield back in that slot. There we go. Alright, well, we just killed ourselves a... Scaladar, which I guess is Latin for mechanical scorpion. That was a fun fight. I was actually worried there for a moment. Alright, I can probably make it to the steps without having to rest again. Or I can rest right before I go down the steps. Well, no, I still have some hags to contend with. Alright, hags. I killed your mechanical scorpion master. Can't you just leave me alone? Leave me in peace? Let me find the stairs? Apparently not. In fact, they're amused by the very idea. Let you find the stairs? Oh dearie, that's no fun at all, is it? Hags talk like this, didn't you know? Didn't you know, dearie? Alright, those are the stairs, and I am on... level 10. We are past the halfway mark, everyone. And if this was an easy playthrough, then we would be on the last level of the dungeon. But you know me. I ain't no goddarn son of a pooch. So, we still have 8 levels to go. Feeling good. Feel like things are going my way. Feel like I'm playing smart. I'm acting smart. Maybe not saying very many smart things. But you know, I feel good. And, we're going to keep going. Tune in tomorrow. I'm Duke of the Bump. Bye, everyone.